officially opening day 2022 for the Colorado Rockies against the Los Angeles Dodgers at Coors Field. Right outside of Coors Field, the unofficial party is officially back. McGregor Square alive and bumping with all the purple and all the fans to boot. Hello, everyone. Welcome to McGregor Square right outside of Tom's Watch Bar. Jenny Kavner with Corey Sullivan. This is fun. Like, we are bursting because it's been 2 years since we've had this party, and we're so glad it's here.
It has, and I liked what Kyle Freeland called it, a normal home opener, where we're actually going to see Coors Field packed to capacity. We love the pomp. We love the circumstance. We love all of that. When they paint the purple line down Blake Street, I think it's incredible. And how often do we ever get the queen to come down amongst the people in Jenny Kavner?
Oh, my gosh, please. So many Corey Sullivans on the way over. I was like, security, security. Oh, we got to get out and amongst the people for the former big leaguer here. Look forward to this special one-hour pregame show that we have for you today, getting you all set for first pitch of the 2022 season on the after the 99-day lockout. They were even busier the last month. All of the signings, Jose Iglesias will fill in now for Trevor Story at shortstop. Chad Kuhl added to the rotation. Alex Cole made to the back end of the bullpen. And Chris Bryant, the big splash around Major League Baseball. 7 years, $182 million contract. But wait, there's more. The exclamation point that they had with signing Ryan McMahon to a 6 year, $70 million contract extension. And then making the lineup have even more bop. And that was getting Randall Grichuk from the Toronto Blue Jays as they traded away Raimel Tapia. I'm out of breath going through all the moves, Corey, so I'll hand it right over to you. When you look at this, this made Colorado better, and they did it in just a couple months.
Like Jim Carrey.
Also added a new member to our team, and that is Kelsey Winger. Kelsey, we are so excited to welcome you to Colorado and say happy opening day officially as you take it away with more on Chris Bryant.
Thank you guys so much. And for the record, Corey, she is my queen as well. So glad to see both of you guys out there. Can't wait to get to know Coors Field, McGregor Square, the city of Denver. Excited, excited to be here. But yeah, when you look at the acquisitions the Rockies were able to make
here, we'll take a break here on the extended Rockies pregame report. Looking forward to talking a little more about the backstop of the future, Elias Diaz. That bat turned on hot in the second half. Can it begin the same way today? Managers meetings, but Bill Schmidt leaked it on our air, and I appreciate that. Bud Black always calls opening day a feather in your cap. And for Kyle Freeland, when you start to think about it, the hottest ticket in town on April 8th, the Rockies and the Dodgers. A sold-out crowd expected at Coors Field for opening day. Let's get today's betting preview with Drew Goldfarb. It's brought to you by DraftKings Sportsbook.
Good to see both of you again. Happy opening day. Colorado looking to down the Dodgers on opening day for the second year in a row and make it four straight opening day victories.
Offensively, what he has been able to do with the bat, we've seen the power. Last year, 23 home runs. That was one shy of his career high.
It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, yeah. Ooh, ooh, ooh. And I'm feeling. We'll
There's a reason we call ourselves the Colorado Rockies.
Es una razón por la que nosotros nos llamamos Rockies de Colorado.
We are not defined by just one city, but rather an entire region of baseball fans from every peak and every valley of the Rocky Mountains.
And if the last 2 years has taught us anything,
it's that playing for you is everything.
Did you realize, or you can't remember? Well, adjust your eyes and let them clear. But if you ain't all right, well, just remember, I'm on your side.
Being a good teammate is...
Being a good teammate is just helping everybody get in a position to win.
If someone's having a tough time, understanding that they're having a tough time.
Obviously, this game's really brutal and can take you through some high highs and some low lows.
In the times of good, building them up, and times of bad, building them up. Just come down to caring about the guy next to you.
If a group of guys is together and all on the same page, you can accomplish so much more.
Just remember,
to be a good teammate for me means being the same guy every single day, no matter what happens.
Being consistent.
I like teammates that I show up, I look at them, and they're pretty much the same every day.
The best guys that I've been around were able to not even know if they're going good or bad, because they're always there supporting the guys.
I'm there. I'm an open book. I want to help guys out too, because I want to win just as bad as they do.
I love this team. I just want to do everything for this team.
Definitely good vibes in the clubhouse for sure.
Welcome back to 20th and Blake.
I know the fans are excited to have a true home opener for opening day.
You find the best over there.
We're the staff from Coronado Elementary in Littleton, Colorado.
And we love the Rockies!
From the Ortho Trauma staff at Sky Ridge Medical Center,
go Rockies!
Got it! With high heat.
We're Indian Hills Fire Rescue. We're hoping the Rockies are so hot they need us to put them out.
We're from the Holy Boys and Girls Club.
And we love the Rockies!
We are the labor and delivery nurses at Swedish Medical Center, and
we are on your side, Rockies!
Oh my goodness, what a play! Three-run, walk-off home run! Big punch out there!
This is the Arapahoe County Sheriff's Office.
And we love the Colorado Rockies.
Boy, did he ever lean on that one!
Fire up the fountain, she's gone!
Now there's a chance to see.
He's got it!
We can stop it on our eyes!
Station 28, Denver Fire Department.
We're on your side, Rockies. Fire up the fountain.
Lodo Magic alive and well!
So excited to compete for, you know, the World Series, which is the goal.
Looking forward to them all showing up to watch us make a run.
So we're ready to show it out.
Here come the Rockies. Take a good look. The Orioles see it from all. Opening week is presented by FTX, the official crypto exchange of the MLB. And what a glorious day in downtown Denver. It is time, and look who's in the house. The former Rocky draft pick out of NC State, who knows a little something about throwing the baseball. Russell Wilson throwing out the Rockies' first pitch, and the crowd roaring. And Chris Bryant, he wanted that signed jersey. He was talking about that earlier, and he gets a photo op with Russell Wilson. Full house, as it should be, as the Rockies get together with their old nemesis, the LA Dodgers, to begin the 2022 campaign. So thrilled that you're along with us. So thrilled that we're back to normal with my longtime partner and great friend, Jeff Houston. I'm Drew Goodman. I want to jump right into it. This Rockies team being discounted around the country by a lot of people, but when you go to that clubhouse, they acquired and signed one of the best players on the free agent market in 6'5" Chris Bryant. What has he done in his career? A whole lot. National League Rookie of the Year. The following year, he was the MVP with the Cubs. And oh, by the way, they ended that drought of over than 100 years. Former second-round pick out of the University of San Diego. Wherever he has been, team success has followed. As you see what he did in 2015 when he was the Rookie of the Year, and then the very next year, he was arguably the best player in all of baseball, hitting 39 home runs again in leading the Cubs to a world championship. Last year, he split time between Chicago and San Francisco, a big part in the second half as they went on to 107 victories with San Francisco. Four-time All-Star. Next 7 years, he's going to be wearing the purple. And just moments ago, our Kelsey Wingert caught up with Chris Bryant.
Thank you so much down here, like you said, with Chris Bryant. Holy smokes, opening day finally here. You've been through quite a few of these, but your first as a Rocky. You chose to be here. You wanted to be here, and now you're here. I mean, how different does this opening day feel to you than some of the others in the past?
I mean, it feels different. It's awesome. I mean, I feel like a couple weeks ago, I didn't even have a team, and I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to get going with these guys, and it should be a great day.
He has great success, ends up winning that game 2-1. But for me, and watching over the course of today's game, notice the use of secondary pitches. Last year, even though it was 23 starts, 7-8 record, that ERA in the second half dropped in half. So he is pitching at a very, very high level, and I'll be fascinated to see if he's able to keep the Dodgers off the fastball with the use of multiple changes, guys.
All right, we're ready to go. And for the Dodgers, it starts with Mookie Betts. So Charlie Blackmon, who oftentimes hit the three hole last year, back to his comfort zone of the top of the lineup. And here is the Rockies Southwest batting order for Buddy Black. Chris Bryant, newly acquired. As you know, he'll bat that two spot. Brendan Rodgers, after a very nice season last year, his first kind of full season in the big leagues, he'll bat third. C.J. Cron was terrific last year, 28 home runs. He drove in 92. Ryan McMahon drove in 80-plus. Connor Joe. Randall Grichuk, who comes in the offseason in a trade really just a couple of weeks ago from Toronto. Elias Diaz, who had 18 home runs. And the veteran, Jose Iglesias, got a little pop, hit 27 doubles last year. He'll bat ninth.